Hello, welcome back to the channel and to a new episode of Backseat Adventure, the series where I have a look at adventure games that might have not been in the spotlight at the time when they were released. I've picked three games for this episode that are all interesting in their very own way, so without further ado, let's get this video started.
Sometime later.
Check it out! That's a pumpkin that I planted! Boy, oh boy, this'll make a great jack-o'-lantern!
Yeah, a surimi fart sure packs a punch!
The perfect camouflage.
Nice costume, short stuff.
Chewy Escape from F5 is a classic point-and-click adventure, developed by the German company Playbyte and released in 1995. Most notable to me were the high production values, there are a lot of cutscenes, very nice hand-drawn pixel art graphics and a complete voiceover. You play as Chewy, the little purple alien guy who is looking for his partner that crashed on planet Earth after a mission went wrong. The first part of the game sees you in the Borg prison, evil, slimy, stupid aliens that have caught you on your mission and you have to escape in order to find your partner. You do succeed to get to planet Earth, but unfortunately you also crash your own spaceship and need to hide from the humans to avoid a panic and too much attention. Tonally, the game is quite weird. It seems to be made to appeal to kids because, well, you have this quirky Saturday morning cartoon humor, but then you also have more mature themes and also a bit of a sexual undertone.
What kind of job is that?
A position as a secretary.
What are the requirements?
I can see that you meet the most important requirements.
Then again, it's a game from the 90s, so I guess being a bit edgy and horny is not that much out of the ordinary. It actually kinda reminded me of the Adventures of Willy Beamish that has the same conflicting tones in some parts of the game. Regarding the puzzles, it starts out very easy, that's why I also had the first impression it might be targeted to a younger audience, but after you've managed to escape the prison and the whole world opens up a bit, it gets a bit more complicated and there are some moon logic puzzles in there for sure. But those are not the worst offenders and at least there are not dead ends or cheap death. The controls are a bit annoying, unfortunately. You have to hold the right mouse button and then move your mouse to the right or to the left to select the action, instead of just having a mouse cursor to do that, but you get used to that after a while. The bigger issues I had were technical, there were a lot of dialogue errors and animations that didn't play correctly, and I also had a few crashes and freezes. I don't know if that's an issue with the Scum VM version or also with the original game. It doesn't happen too often, but you should save your games regularly just in case. I felt that the first part where you have to escape the prison was a bit boring visually and from the actions, but if you get to the later part, it definitely picks up in pace. Overall, I think it's a neat game. Maybe use a walkthrough to avoid the moon logic puzzles, maybe just try yourself. The humor is a bit hit and miss, still, I think it's worth your time. The next game I wanted to talk about is Noctropolis from 1994, developed by Flashpoint Productions. This game always intrigued me because it has this crazy and very unique superhero world that comes from a comic and that the protagonist gets teleported into. The story doesn't make much sense and seems like just an excuse for raunchy FMV and crazy visuals, but that's an excuse as good as any if you ask me. The writing is all over the place, over the top, overly dramatic and just very enjoyable. And the actors clearly had fun performing in their roles. As for the gameplay, well, it's not great. Many puzzles make just as much sense as the overall storyline, and you can easily die on many occasions. You will also get in a few dead man walking and dead end situations there, but I heard that the remaster from Night Dive Studios that released 2015 has toned those down somewhat. The controls are also a bit weird. You have this menu where you select an action and then you select the object that you want to perform the action on. But for the inventory it's a bit different. You just select an item, and if you can use this item on the current screen, it will automatically select with what it will use the item. So that makes things a bit easier because, well, you don't have so many combinations, but with the very convoluted puzzles this doesn't help too much, unfortunately. But if you're looking for a unique, very 90s experience, this game is one of a kind. So I still recommend playing it, but probably with a walkthrough or lots and lots of patience. Want to see more retro gaming videos? Then check out my channel or subscribe to it if you don't want to miss out when new ones get released. It's greatly appreciated. Thank you!
Another fantastic round of Spank the Virgin. That's right, lucky game player. You get to get in that bed and slap the bum of several unspoiled beauties. All of them personally inspected by me, your host, Ralph the Wonderlam. So adjust your joystick and grab your mouse. It's time to Spank the Virgin.
Golly.
Ow!
Oh my.
Yes.
Naughty little bum.
Ow!
How'd you do?
More.
Yeah, another horny game. I wonder what my subconscious is trying to tell me here. But don't worry, in general Monty Python and the Quest for the Holy Grail is rather tame. I argued with myself if this really qualifies as a point-and-click game or if it's more of a hidden object game, but as you do have some kind of inventory and you do travel different places with an overarching narrative, I'd say it made the cut. Recommending this game is really simple. If you're a fan of the movie, then this game is probably for you, especially if you want to see more of it and interact with it in some silly ways. But be warned, there is not much more material in there than you already know from the movie. It's more like a remix. You know what you're getting yourself into when you find out that you can just go back on the first screen and grab the Holy Grail from the title screen and just win the game. That's about as random and bizarre as the gameplay gets, which is sometimes a detriment, because a few things are a bit hard to find out what the game expects you to do, but in general the game is rather easy, and most quote-unquote puzzles can be solved by just randomly clicking on the images and see what happens. The good thing is that even if you click on wrong parts of the image, you always get some funny animation or a joke, so it's really enjoyable to discover everything that there is to find. Generally, the game is separated in a few different scenes that all correlate to scenes from the actual movie. You always need to find a hidden coconut, and if you do so, you can proceed to the next scene. There are also quite a lot more items besides the coconuts, and some of them are needed in the end, but you can always go back to previous scenes if you have missed one. So it's really easy to unlock all scenes up until the end, and you can experience about 90% of the game even without solving the more intricate puzzles, but if you really want to finish the game, then you have to go the whole mile. Sprinkled in between the scenes are optional minigames, which oftentimes are extremely simplistic but funny nonetheless because of the theming with the Holy Grail movie. The game was released in 1996, both for Windows 3.1 and Windows 95. Not sure if there are any difference, I played the Windows 3.1 version because, well, there are just so few games for that platform that I always enjoyed going back to it. I've watched the movie probably about 10 times, but this game still managed to get a few giggles out of me. So don't miss out, it's not very long anyway. And that's it for the second episode of Backseat Adventures. I hope you liked the selection of games this time around and will tune in next time. And with that, see ya!